Okay, Mark. Like to ask about your preseason and how it has progressed, and with the fact that D2 is actually starting a couple weeks later, has that played into your plans as to how you conducted the preseason for cross country?
It gave us an extra week to sort of ease into the season. Hard to believe that it's already been 3 weeks already, and we'll have a month of practice in before we get our first competition.
How have the newcomers assimilated into the collegiate running program?
On the men's side, there's naturally some growing pains just getting used to the extra distance. It's a longer race, so we have to increase their distance and their volume, and we got to do that gradually and cautiously just because we never know how they'll respond to it.
Who are going to be some of the runners that you're going to look for to lead the squad this year on the men's side?
The four veterans all came back pretty solid. They did their work over the summer. Parker, Calvert, Ivan Henderson, Wyatt Whitman, and Christian England, they are ready to roll. They look solid all 3 weeks of practice here. On the women's side, Andrea Liddell, she did the same thing. She wants to leave a legacy, and she's well on that way to it.
Well, on both squads this year, you've got a little bit more of veteran leadership. Mm-hmm. Women's side, you've got, I think, four runners who've been together for 3 or 4 years. Same thing on the men, although a little bit younger, but still you've got a lot of experience. How does that play into the season?
It's good because they set the tone. So I've asked the veterans to reach out, make sure throughout the summer they reached out to all the new runners, and they had a lot of group chats, and they kept in touch. They kept accountable to each other. Couldn't ask for a better group of guys.
What are going to be the keys to success for us here in 2019?
Obviously, we have a little more numbers than we did last year, but again, it always comes down to health. We got to nip little things in the bud, make sure we kind of avoid that mid-early October flu cold that goes around campus. So as long as we can keep them healthy and keep them rolling, I'm expecting big things this year.
Let me ask you one other question, too, about one of our women's runners. Emma Driggers earned Academic All-America Honors last year from COSIDA, which is a very prestigious award where it's voted on by SIDs nationwide, and people figure in the academic side and the athletic side. She spent last spring studying abroad. How important to a program is to have a student-athlete like that who shows that it is possible to be a good athlete and a good student at the same time?
Oh, without a doubt. She's a role model for everyone. Not only the academic accolade, she's a double major, too. So they set the tone, and it trickles down throughout the freshmen. They know that this girl can do it. And, you know, we had several athletes in the past on the guy's side that didn't have the exact recognition that Emma did, but, you know, they've gone on to go into masters, and we have one or two wrapping up on their PhD right now. So, I mean, it's pretty phenomenal to be surrounded by that kind of bright, young athletes.
Mark, talk a little bit about the dynamic of having a pair of sisters running on the women's squad this year, and also a female runner who is the younger sister of a former male runner who finished up last year.
I think that speaks extremely well of the university and their experience that they're having here, that their younger siblings want to share in that experience and have a similar experience as well. I can't speak enough about the university and where we're going in that direction and the atmosphere that we can provide them.
And let's talk a little bit about our first meet. Where is it? When is it? And where are we running? What kind of course are we on?
The first meet is back up at Lumberton, Luther Britt Park. UNC Pembroke's been nice enough to host the conference this year. I believe it's their first meet since Larry Rogers retired, and we used to enjoy that course quite a bit, so we're looking forward to getting back onto it.
And that'll give us a chance to see the course before the conference meet later on in late October, correct?
Exactly, and that'll be a good measuring stick to see if the program's working, see how much improvement we have. The only variable will obviously be the weather, and hopefully it stays dry next week and stays dry in October.